We were the only Indian family in our small southern town. I was teased every day for being brown. So anyone that wants to question it can go back and look at what I've said on how hard it was to grow up in the deep south as a brown girl.
Nikki, this is why I have a problem with your approach. And America's sick of the bullshit that you're doing to say, here, feel sorry for me because I was brown as a kid. Cry me a flipping river for taking that approach. America's fed up with these types of comments, okay? You made it to the top. Instead, the message could be, look, you know, everybody has their own set of challenges of coming to the top. We all have ours. You've had yours. Rather, you use it as a method of trying to divide and need some sympathy votes or people to feel sorry for. Again, it's not attractive.
Oh, folks. Patrick Bet-David completely tore apart Nikki Haley the other day. You gotta see this, okay? And you certainly love to see it because you know how we feel about Nikki Haley on this channel. You know we think she is an insufferable, feminist, woke in many ways, corporate, warmongering shill, just all the worst labels really do apply to her, okay? There's a reason I've said she is the Trojan horse of the conservative movement. And Patrick Bet-David here completely masterfully calls it out. And we'll talk about it in a second. But first, to set the stage and the context, this is in reference to what Nikki Haley said about a week ago, where she was basically crying racism, right? Speaking exactly like Kamala Harris or Elizabeth Warren would speak about, I was a victim of racism growing up. And just listen to this for yourself and ask yourself if this is how you expect a conservative, quote unquote, to talk about America. All right, take a listen here.
We were the only Indian family in our small southern town. I was teased every day for being brown.
Okay. So first of all, she's playing victim. Like I said, transplant those words onto Kamala Harris, who's also part Indian. She, you know, seems to forget half the time that she is, but whenever she needs donor money from Indian people, she's like, oh yes, I'm very Indian. But you could put that exact transcript on Kamala Harris and sound the exact same. Like this is how a Democratic candidate speaks. That's the truth. Playing victim, woman card, which she does all the time. Now she's doing the race card. Now she's saying I'm a POC woman, right? But even furthermore, not only is this an annoying use of the victim card, you know, trying to put down, she's from South Carolina, she's from the South, she won't shut up all the time about that, but at the same time insulting them, you know, trying to label her own people as racist. But forget all of that for a moment. Let me say, I have serious doubts that this even happened. Okay? As a brown woman, like, technically, yes, Nikki, you are Indian, but you're not a dark Indian, right? You look nothing like Vivek Ramaswamy, for instance. I'm not the only one who says and believes this. Nikki Haley passes for white, okay? And you use a fake European name anyway. So, and you have the same skin complexion as basically like Ron DeSantis, right? You could totally pass for Italian. So she's here claiming that she faced racism growing up every single day, not an occasional joke. Hey, one time someone said something to her. Folks, do we really believe that growing up in South Carolina, this woman was getting bullied every single day for being Indian? When she looks white, she passes for white, she uses a white name. It's so ridiculous and insufferable. So not only is she playing the victim card, she's 99% very likely lying about it. So people tore her apart for this. Although in fairness, she did say this right before the New Hampshire primary. And I think when you consider the fact that what was her electoral strategy in New Hampshire? It was to win over the votes of Democrats, right? It was to win over Biden voters. We've told that story a million times. And so it's pretty clear now to me, seeing a video like that, that she was speaking to Biden voters. She was speaking to Democrats. Because, of course, conservatives look at that and ask, who the heck are you talking to? Like, you really think that type of language appeals to conservatives? She's not campaigning to conservatives. She's campaigning to liberals, and she's campaigning to You know, Democrat Joe Biden donors like Reid Hoffman, who gave her money before this. But anyways, let's listen to Patrick Bet-David tear her apart for this, because I just love this. I just love to hear this. Here you go.
Nikki, this is why I have a problem with your approach, and why so many people we talk to in the street, regular people, not elitists like you, I'm just talking regular people, who will look at you and the way you're packaging your candidacy versus Vivek. Okay. Vivek never uses color as a feel sorry for me. Never.
Right.
You use it to get sympathy. Okay.
Right.
Vivek.
And gender, by the way, too. She's actually done that part way more than the race card, in fairness, but both of them are equally off-putting.
The people who are voting for, he's also Indian. Okay. He's not sitting there saying, I was teased for being brown. Okay. There is no feeling you get from Vivek for being a victim. I post a video the other day. And by the way, we did this video while I was in Palm Beach. I want you to see this here, Adam, because most people think I made this video because of Vivek. It just kind of timed perfectly. I'm going to show you when I posted this video, Adam, and I want you to tell me the date. Okay. Mm-hmm. When is the date for this video? Okay. Boom, 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 boom. Here's the date. What's the date? January what?
It says January 15th at 4:57 p.m.
Can you pull up when the Babylon Bee story came up about Vivek and 7-Eleven? Okay. And it's just so accidental that the timing of it was perfect. What's the date? Is it that one? Go to Babylon Bee website. Okay, what's the date on that?
16th.
That's the next day.
The next day.
So they were inspired by you.
I get this video and I put it on Twitter, not thinking anything about it, but watch what Vivek does. Go to Vivek's Twitter account. Vivek says, thank you for coming and don't forget to grab a Slurpee.
He's got a sense.
One side.
See, that's the way to handle it, right? You don't make this big, oh, you need to feel bad for me because of this. No, you sort of own it. You make a joke out of it. Vivek handled this very well, and I know some conservatives were not happy that the Babylon Bee posted that, but first of all, it's a satire site, and ultimately, if we can't learn to laugh at ourselves, then like, why do you think the country's so miserable? I mean, people say that all the time, conservatives say that all the time, the death of comedy. Well, that goes both ways, and props to Vivek for doing that. But again, you know, if Nikki Haley if they said this about Nikki Haley, who's also Indian, what would she say? They're saying it because I'm a brown woman. Right? And there's the truth. That's how a liberal, let me say that, that's how a liberal would react to it. Vivek reacted the way a conservative would react to it. Just saying. Okay.
If I would have done this with Nikki Haley, she says, this is why racism exists.
Racism.
What does Vivek say? Please grab a Slurpee on the way out. Nikki, America loves Vivek for this reason.
Yep.
And America's sick of the bullshit that you're doing to say, here, feel sorry for me because I was brown as a kid.
Yeah.
Cry me a flipping river for taking that approach. America's fed up with these types of comments, okay? You made it to the top. Instead, the message could be, look, you know, everybody has their own set of challenges of coming to the top. We all have ours. You've had yours. But look, what racism? Look at me now. We've had a black president. We've had all these people that are winning at the highest level. Why are we making this a big deal today? Rather, you use it as a method of trying to divide and need some sympathy votes or people to feel sorry for. Again, it's not attractive.
That's what she's doing.
From a leader standpoint, it's not attractive. And by the way, somebody said something yesterday. It was so interesting. They said Tulsi Gabbard is everything Nikki Haley wished she could have been.
Wow.
Okay. Wished she could have been, and she's not. Versus Nikki Haley is closer to a Hillary Clinton than a Tulsi Gabbard.
No doubt.
I would argue that Nikki Haley literally says that Hillary Clinton was her political inspiration. So that's not a joke. The reason she ran for office, she writes about this in her book. She talks about it. The reason she got involved in politics is because she was inspired by Hillary Clinton. So I would actually argue that Hillary Clinton, minus the president part, is everything that Nikki Haley wishes she was, because Hillary Clinton actually held a meaningful foreign policy position in the White House, unlike Nikki Haley, who is the UN ambassador, aka a completely useless position. Now she turns around and claims, I have foreign policy experience. you gave meaningless speeches to a meaningless institution. Yeah, great job, right? Great job. And that's not to say that Hillary Clinton was a good Secretary of State, but at least she can say she was Secretary of State, right? And then Hillary Clinton, of course, actually became at one point the nominee of her party for the presidency. Nikki Haley didn't even get that far. So just pointing that out, right?
People want somebody that's real, that's talking to you. She does not give me that. And the more she talks, the more feeling I get that her and Hillary are related.
100. And by the way, can you go back to that video? Just how, you know, my grandmother once told me before she passed away, never trust anybody that has leather shoulder pads. Look at, what the hell? Whoever picked
that's
that
what grandma
outfit,
told you. Of,
my
of
grandmother
anything.
Said, never
that's,
trust.
That's wise, by the way.
Pat, do you look at with the collar?
Never question a Syrian wisdom.
Thank you.
There it is right respect. There. But by the way, you got to give credit to Vivek Ramaswamy because he never uses the race cards. He never uses it as an excuse. Give his right. whole argument is against wokeness yeah. and DEI and ESG. So it's antithetical to what he stands for. What he tweeting about the Slurpee that people thought that he was going to be upset. He leaned into the joke. That's amazing. You saw that what he did the other day. You know, UPS did a big tweet and he retweeted, "What could Brown do for you?" Like, Vivek don't play when it comes to jokes and race. He enjoys it.
It's just unattractive. It's just nothing about, by the way, it's like the whole Juicy Smollett. Like you want attention.
Juicy Smollett.
Juicy Smollett. Yeah, my bad. But it's like she knows she's drowning. So what card do you play? You racist. Feel bad for me. As if that's going to get you votes. She's dead in the water.
Tom, be honest. For you, a man that's open-minded, do you sympathize with the level of racism that she experienced as a child for being brown?
No, I think Elizabeth Warren has been completely exposed for the things that she... Oh, wait a minute, I'm sorry. We're talking about somebody else? Oh, yeah. Nikki Haley.
Well, yeah, exactly. Exactly. But again, why are they indistinguishable in rhetoric? Because they're appealing to the same voters. It's the truth.
Honest. Haley has once again has played the, the Elizabeth Warren card, trying to use color, stay race or association to create affinity. Yeah. And but it's affinity not with achievement and anything to be proud of. It's affinity with victimhood. And I think the whole victimhood thing is disgusting to people. I think that's what makes Vivek, attractive to people in his message. He said, "So you know what? He's not a victim. He's..."
Well, again, it shows that Nikki Haley comes from a liberal moral framework. That's what this is really about. She may believe in low taxes or something, but she subscribes to the identity politics stuff. She subscribes to this, grievance politics of victimhood and all that. Because that's who she is deep down, right? Deep down, she is a feminist. Deep down, she is, I would argue, philosophically a liberal, right? So...
he's just getting up there and he's doing his thing, speaking it, and he is who he is.
Who do you think's decision that was to do that? Because, I mean, she has a team, right? Is that her decision to bring that up? Or somebody goes, you know what? Go for the brown racist.
It's her strategists and handlers that are telling her, don't bring up slavery.
Guys,
that's what they didn't want her to say.
I'm going to tell you this.
Go ahead.
I'm going to tell you this. It's 100% her decision. What are you talking about?
Yeah, absolutely. It, of course, people can make that excuse. Oh, her handlers were telling her that. No. She's been playing the girl boss card, by the way, guys, long before she ran for president. Okay. I'm kind of proud to say that. I was, even when I was first starting politics back in high school, I was never a Nikki Haley fan. I remember like 2019. Some of you people may pretend like you never said it now. You're like, yeah, I want Nikki Haley to be president. I always saw it from a mile away, right? She is an internalized feminist. She is neoconservative. She's a big hawk on the issues and stuff. And, truly, I didn't know the extent of her corruption, but I assumed it. And of course, we have learned that now. But this is to say that it 100%, that's not her donor speaking. That's not her consultant speaking. That might have been true of Ron DeSantis' campaign. I don't think it's true here. No, that whole victim card about, I was always bullied growing up, I'm a woman, I'm a brown woman. That's who she is deep down. Okay? Again, she gets that from people like her political idol, Hillary Clinton. So that's the truth. Folks, this may be one of the last videos we do dunking on Nikki Haley, although inevitably when she drops out, So long as she still stays in the public eye, I'm going to keep going after her because, you know, this with Ron DeSantis, for instance, you know, once he dropped out of the race, endorsed Trump. Truthfully, I don't really have much bad to say about the guy, and I wasn't really spending my time tearing into him on the campaign trail anyway. But it's like, OK, fair enough. But Nikki Haley is going to be a stain. Is that too harsh of a word? She's going to be a thorn in the side of the GOP for a very long time to come. Okay, and I guarantee even when she drops out, she's not going away. In fact, I guarantee you, the moment she drops out, she is 100% going to endorse Trump. You know, people may think, oh, she's going to try. No. Because she wants power. She's going to endorse Trump. She's going to try to weasel her way back into our good graces. And we're not going to let it happen. So you know what? I take that back. This is not going to be one of the last videos we make on Nikki Haley, but it may be one of the last ones we make on her as a presidential candidate, because as we covered earlier this week, it's all collapsing. Her donors are dropping out. The RNC may declare her out of the race. We'll have to see. But that said, folks, let me know your thoughts on all of this in the comment section down below. What'd you think of Patrick Bet David? What do you think of Nikki Haley? And be sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if you are new, and until next time, Alpha Moves Only, God bless, have a very good day, and peace.